Hi, I'm Andrea from AWS. There's no question that when it comes to our customers, AWS Cloud Technologies is key to handling big data. At the same time, that means that all that data has to be clearly understood. Let's take a look at how some of our customers are using AWS analytics tools to gain deep, meaningful insights. San Diego Gas and Electric is using image recognition and machine learning to reduce wildfire risks.
So this is where IAPU really starts to deliver value. Mm-hmm. So we first process the images in our S3 bucket using step function workflows. Okay. That image processing involves things like resizing, generating thumbnails, and extracting metadata, like the capture angle and capture source of the images.
So what's the business logic for the capture source? Can you walk us through that?
Sure. So the capture source is different depending on, or the business logic is different depending on the capture source. So for drones, we have many images taken from many different angles of a known utility asset. Mm. For the mobile phones and fleet vehicles, we have images taken from a consistent angle of an unknown asset. So we need some business logic to derive what that asset is.
So how does recognition and lookout for vision support those use cases?
Yeah, so for the first use case, we have asset detection. The second use case is damage detection. We found that recognition works well for detecting large assets, so things like utility poles and cross arms, but it's not so effective for small assets. So in that case, we pass the images from recognition to Lookout for Vision, and Lookout for Vision is able to identify small assets in the images, like arresters and bushings.
Oh, interesting. And then where do you store this information?
Yeah, so we write the results out to an S3 bucket from recognition and Lookout for Vision, and then we query those results using Athena and combine them with business rules to refine our predictions.
Okay, so let's assume you have a false positive, and how do you address that?
Sure, I'll have to talk a little bit about this flow down here to get there. So what we do is we bring the raw inference results from Athena into Aurora, which is a Postgres database for us and serves as a database for the rest of the application. We then make the data available from Aurora out to knowledgeable end users. The end users are able to identify false positives and false negatives in the predictions, which we then feed back to the model training process.
Analytics can also power farming. Here's how Alter is building the future of farming using IoT-enabled livestock and pasture management.
And how do you ingest and process all this data from your devices?
We need to combine the data coming from the two sources. So the first thing we do is putting that on the Kinesis stream. So this is the raw stream of data. So the data here is in a binary format and can be duplicated because it comes from two different sources. Then we have a Lambda function that consumes the data from here, dedupes the data, and also decodes it and makes it a lot more digestible to the upstream services. So we ship it as a JSON to the next Kinesis stream. So this is the processed Kinesis stream data. And this one is the main stream in the system. So we have lots of different parts of the backend consuming data from here. One of them is an Apache Flink application that runs on top of Kinesis Analytics. So what this application does is aggregating this this cow location data into buckets of 10 minutes. And we also enrich the data with a geoindex, and we use this geoindex later on to do aggregation. So once the data is ready, we just ship as a file to S3, and we store, we use farm ID and data as the partition keys in order to avoid hot partitions.
Awesome. There must be a lot of data. How does farmers actually make use of this data?
Sure. We have a feature in our app, which is a cow location heat map. So this shows where cows have been like on the last 6 or 12 months. So when the farmer wants to request that report, the app sends a request to our backend, which is hosted on ACS Fargate. And the ACS Fargate will do the orchestration on querying the data. The data is stored on S3, as I mentioned. So we use Athena to do the actual querying. So this is a classic MapReduce problem where you have to go like through a lot of data points and aggregate it and count it. So Athena does a great job at it. We can process roughly 25 million data points in roughly 10 seconds. And then when the result of the query is done, the ACS Fargate application will go to S3, get the data, and then send it back to the app, and the app can render a nice heat map.
Finally, let's see how MobileEye is processing data from 70 million cars driving around the world.
So let's dive deep into the architecture. So you collected the data, move it to dynamic RAM. What do you do with this data?
So as I mentioned before, data is stored in S3. From there, it is being pulled to SQS and then being processed by our EKS workers. Those EKS workers actually scale automatically according to the relevant SQS queue size and can scale up to 800% during a day. At the next phase, we pre-process, format, store the data in S3, and then send it to a set of algorithms implemented by step functions executing multiple Lambda functions.
Can you give me an example for one of those functions?
Yes, of course, Boaz. So one example for an algorithm can be the extraction of potential construction zones from vehicles.
Okay, then what?
Then the results are being exposed to the rest of the system's components. For example, a sophisticated clustering mechanism which combines observations from different vehicles into clustered events. Another example can be our aggregation mechanism, which aggregates data by time and road segments.
Cool, so you already collected some data, got some insights. What are you doing with these insights?
So, for example, if I'm a city planner, the platform can provide me accurate hourly data regarding pedestrian and bicycle traffic, which allows me to plan better roads and cities.
Okay, and how can I get this data from the system?
So after the data was calculated, we save it into Elasticsearch and CockroachDB. At the next phase, we service this data to our customers using an EKS cluster. This EKS cluster is serving a secured REST API and web application, which our users are using to consume the data.
Okay, so I can actually got the insights from this. I wonder how many events the system can process.
So today we use between 100 to 800 EKS workers in order to process around 10 million observations per day.
Okay, 10 million observations per day doesn't sound much. Like you have 70 million cars driving all over the world. The amount of data each car can produce. Why is that?
That's an excellent question, Boaz. We actively limit the amount of data flowing into the system in order to control costs and allow a per-per-use model.
We hope you enjoyed looking at how our customers are using analytics in their AWS cloud solutions. Find out more by watching the full episodes from the links in the description. And keep watching. This is My Architecture.